Vice President Pence visits our Langley Research Center, science results related to water on Jupiter, and studying the darkest areas of the moon. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Vice President Mike Pence and our Administrator Jim Bridenstine visited our Langley Research Center in Virginia on February 19th to highlight work being done at Langley in support of our Artemis program, which plans to return astronauts to the surface of the moon.
In order to succeed, we are going to continue to focus on the mission over the means. We want to challenge each one of you here at Langley. Consider every available option and platform to meet our goals.
In honor of Black History Month, the Vice President recognized the contributions of former Langley mathematician Katherine Johnson and her family, as well as others in the audience and around the agency. The first science results from our Juno mission's investigation into the amount of water in Jupiter's atmosphere estimate that at the equator, water makes up about 0.25% of the molecules, almost three times that of the Sun. These are also the first findings on Jupiter's abundance of water since our 1995 Galileo mission suggested Jupiter might be extremely dry compared to the Sun, a suggestion based not on liquid water, but on the presence of water's molecular components in the Sun. NASA has awarded nearly $1 million to eight university teams through a competitive student challenge to build sample lunar payloads that demonstrate innovative ways to study permanently shadowed areas of the moon. Technologies designed to collect data, generate wireless power for future infrastructure, and enable autonomous mobility in these extreme environments could be used in preparation for landing the first woman and next man on the moon in 2024 through our Artemis program. This past week, we announced that more than 100 teams from around the world are expected to participate in our Human Exploration Rover Challenge, April 17th through 18th, near our Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama. The annual event features student-built human-powered rovers navigating a course simulating terrain found on the Moon and Mars, as well as other planets, moons, and asteroids. On February 18th, Northrop Grumman's Cygnus cargo spacecraft arrived at the International Space Station, loaded with more than 7,500 pounds of research and supplies for the crew on board the station. Northrop Grumman launched the Cygnus 3 days earlier from our Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. This is the company's 13th commercial resupply services mission for NASA. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.